guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to.
And not another. We brought nothing into this world. And it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord is good. A stronghold in the day of trouble. And he knows those who trust in him. Fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you.
Even I am he who comforts you.
you. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. Oh, but be of good cheer. But I have overcome the world. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also make intercession for us. Who shall separate us? Oh, hallelujah. From the love of Christ. Shall tribulation or distress, oh, have mercy on us, Lord, of persecution of famine, a nakedness of peril or sword. Yet, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded, Lord have mercy, that neither death nor life nor angels nor principalities nor powers nor things present, or things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comfort us in all our tribulation. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Thank you, Jesus. The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is he weary, and there is no searching of his understanding. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. But those, I say, but those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Blessed be the Lord who daily loads us with benefit. The God of our salvation. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God is our refuge and our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust. Surely He shall deliver us from the snare of the fowl and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover us with His feathers, and under His wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord, who is your refuge, even the Most High, your habitation. For I know whom I have believed, and am persuaded that He's able to keep what I have committed to Him until that day. Yes, for I know that my Redeemer lives. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. But to me, to live is Christ, and to die is gain. For I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, which is far better. But we know that if our earthly house, this tent, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. We are confident, yes, well pleased rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, hallelujah, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgives all your iniquity, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from destruction, who crowns you with the loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfies your mouth with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord is a merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. He has not dealt with us according to our sins, nor punished us according to our iniquities. For as the heavens are high above the earth, so great is His mercy toward those who fear Him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has He removed our transgressions from us. As a father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear Him. The Lord was her shepherd. She did not want. He made her to lie down in green pasture. He led her beside the still waters. He restored her soul. He led her righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though she walked through the valley of the shadow of death, she feared no evil, for God was with her. Her rod and her staff, and they comforted her. He prepared a table before her in the presence of her enemies. Hallelujah. He anointed her head with oil, and her cup did run over. And surely goodness and mercy followed her all the days of her life. And she now dwells in the house of the Lord forever and ever and ever. For our citizenship is in heaven, from which we all so eagerly wait for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly body that it may be conformed to his glorious body. But I do not want you to be ignorant, brother, concerning those who have fallen asleep, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope. Thank you, Jesus. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus. But this we say to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord will by no means precede those who are asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. And then we who are alive and remain shall be called together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord, saints of God. Praise the Lord, saints of God. Even though it feels like and it seems like it's a sad occasion, but one thing you know about the apostle, the prophetess, hallelujah, she was a worshiper. She loved God even in the midst of our tears. We still can give God some glory. Come on, let's put our hands together and tell God thank you. Put our hands together and tell God we know what the moment of God is. Glory to God. Yeah, glory. Hallelujah. We are here to celebrate the life, the love, and the legacy of a phenomenal woman. Each of us knew her in such different ways. But nevertheless, to meet her, you'll never forget her. One thing I learned about my friend, hallelujah, she did it her way. She did it God's way, and she did it her way. And she loved God, and she loved family. But giving glory and honor to the Spirit of God, and to His Son, Jesus, and His rich red royal blood, and to the Holy Ghost and His ministry, to the fivefold ministry, to the apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, the pastor, the teacher, overseer, bishop, elders, friends, but to this waiting family, we want you to know that we love you and we are here for you. Hallelujah. Jesus promised in His word, hallelujah, that He is strength for the day and help and hope for tomorrow. And we tell God, thank you right now in the name of Jesus. One more time, I dare you to put your hand together and tell God, thank you. Hallelujah for His presence and His power and His peace and His provision, because He's God and He is good. And she loved Him. She loved Him. Hallelujah. God, I'm going to miss my plan. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, this is the order of service today. The prayer of comfort, Reverend Clifford Walton. Old Testament scripture, Reverend Willie Green. New Testament scripture, Evangelist Barbara Harris Lynch. A musical selection, Reverend Diane Power. The two-minute reflection, Miss Priscilla Hicks, Miss Carolyn McKinney, Mr. Bryson Streeter. Again, musical selection, Reverend Diane Powell, and the eulogy, Pastor Shirley Strawter. And I'm just looking at her color. She loved purple and yellow. Hallelujah. Royalty and glory. And she knew that she served the King of all kings. And she enjoyed being in His presence and the glory of the Lord. If you will come at this time in order that your name is called. Amen.
Through the Holy Spirit. not my spirit, but the Holy Spirit. Because he know all about it. Everything that was about the Holy Spirit. So let us pray.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Lord Jesus, as we enter into your presence, we praise and thanksgiving. Asking you first and foremost to forgive us for all our sins. Lord, if there be anything that's on the line hindering us from getting through to you today, we ask you to allow the Holy Spirit to kill it right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we take authority and dominion over the COVID virus, God. The number one death killer that's loose in the earth, Lord. We bind it to the blood of Jesus. You told us in your word, whatsoever we bind on earth, you will bind it in heaven. Whatsoever we loose on earth, you will loose it in heaven. So we bind COVID to the blood of Jesus. We loose your spirit today. Asking you, Lord, to allow the Holy Spirit to have his way in this service. To touch the souls and the hearts of her Cyril and God, her son, her grandson, and her husband, God. Keep him going. Let the Holy Spirit touch them right now. And all of her siblings, God, her sisters, her brothers, God, we bring them before you right now. Asking you, God, to allow the Holy Spirit to minister your peace. The peace that you give, not as the world gives, God. The way you say you give your peace, Lord, unto the family. And we thank you for it right now. In the name of Jesus. Then, Father, we lift up all of the friends, the neighbors, the loved ones, even our enemies, God. Because you told us to pray for our enemies, God. The one that despitefully misuses, God. But, Lord, we just want to include everybody. We're not overlooking nobody, God. Because, God, that's not your way of doing it. We just want to follow your protocol, God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, today, we ask you to saturate this place. Consecrate it with your anointing, God. And destroy every yoke of the enemy right now. In the name of Jesus. Lord, just have your way. Lord, we thank you for a ring of word today. Through the pastor that you're going to use, Pastor Strong, God. To break your bread to the congregation on today. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we praise you now. J.W. Funeral Home, God, their service unto you, as they render unto the family, God. Pray, God, that you continue to keep them healed, healthy, and whole as you allow them to go and continue to do what they do, God. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, I praise you right now for all that you've done, all that you're going to do. Thanking you for being in our midst right now. I ask you to take over your service. Do what you do, Lord. And we ask you of all these blessings and miracles in our son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
To this grieving family, we come to read the Old Testament, Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou all with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou prepareth a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anoint my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. the word of God for the people of God.
Count Jesus' joy.
Amen.
To be here today. Because we are a part of this family. And we just want to let you know. Tell me that I am.
to continue her legacy.
Yeah.
And I know that we are going to breathe because she was such a beautiful woman. She was such a loving person. And like I said, she was such a giver. But I just know that she would want us to rejoice in this time. Because she is doing greater things for God now. And so I'm just so grateful, and I just tell everyone in this room again to continue her legacy. And if she might have called you before she passed away, and she told y'all to forgive somebody, even if they might have hurt you, my best suggestion is for y'all to do it, because she was an apostle. And I know that she's not here in the flesh. She's still moving, and she's watching over us. So I just want to say that I love everybody in this room, and that Mama will be blessed, and she will be missed. But y'all just continue to walk upright. And like I said, whatever she might have told you guys, make sure that you do it.
Amen.
Because one thing I do know is that she truly worked for God. And she truly loved God. And she wanted her armor bearers and everyone that went forth in her life to be pleasing in God's sight so that we can make it to heaven like she did. So I'm just grateful. I'm grateful for everybody coming and the love and the friends and her family. And I just hope that y'all be blessed, and just remember your loved one like I will, because she's very, very, very dear to my heart.
Yeah.
But I'm going to try to do everything I can to continue her legacy.
Amen.
And to make her proud. And I know that finishing school and doing some good things for my life will really make her proud, but to also just continue my relationship with God.
Amen.
And to not neglect what she taught me, so I'm just grateful.
We know that she's in heaven, looking down and still touching or looking over folks who she loved. And y'all just remember the love that she had for everyone and continue to pass that legacy on. Thank
about when my mom and my dad always told me is I was really lucky to have a grandmother like her. You know, as y'all know, you know how she felt about me. it was such a big thing that even the other side of my family, they know how they always mess with me about it. Don't mess with him, his grandmother's gonna come get you. and the one thing that always stood out to me about her and to everyone else is as the years, you know, I spent every summer, pretty much every summer, every Thanksgiving and every Christmas with her. And the one thing that always resonated with me was how much she touched everyone's life. I would watch her and I would see how much, you know, how much of herself she would give to everyone else, not just me. One time, twice, she came down to Houston to visit me and my family, and you know, she, even though they had barely met her and everything, she touched their soul. They always talked about her, always had high regards and everything, and I noticed that was one thing that every time she met someone or every time she was around people is that she not only brought them together, but she also touched them in a different way. You know, even if we went to like a Wendy's and you know, they had like flies everywhere, you know, that was her biggest pet peeve. she would go in there and yelling and screaming, but by the time like we're leaving, she'd be praying for them. Remember her and bless her is do be in service of God as she always was and make sure that we, you know, we try to be in service of others. She was a giving person. She touched everyone that she was around. So at least for me, I'm gonna try to be, you know, more servant and more giving on to others and more forgiving because I know that's what she would have wanted. And I know that's the message and everything that she preached. I know that that's all she really wanted. So,
he can't help me to fall. Causes the earth
own productive power. Grass planted tree and lovely smelling flower bring us comfort at any given hour. He who holds tomorrow has the master plan. He chooses from his garden a woman, child, or man. So let us trust in him, the Lord our God who saved. For death is not the end. There is life beyond our graves. The Lord who sends the rain, hallelujah, to refresh the earth with shower, will comfort you and bless you this very present hour. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's take comfort in the fact is she all right. We are behind to live out this life. Amen. With all of these troubles and trials, but God promised in his word that he would give us the strength that we need. Each of us are given the strength that we need for the task, for the journey, for the job that God has assigned to us. And God had assigned a whole lot of stuff to apostles, and she wore it well. Not only did she wear it well, she dressed it well. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So I'm going to be coming from 2 Timothy 4, 6, and 8 because she loved the word. Amen. And she really wants everybody to be saved and have a loving relationship with the Lord. Amen. One thing I learned is she knew you can't make anybody except the Lord. Hallelujah. Everybody time is set that we're going to meet him one way or the other. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 2 Timothy 4, 6, and 8. So I have two versions, but I'm going to read to you King James Version first of 2 Timothy, hallelujah, thank you, Lord, chapter 4, verses 6 through 8, King James. For I am now ready to be offered, in other words, to be poured out like a drink offering, hallelujah, and the time of my departure is at hand. In other words, saying my flight leaving at so and so, I see y'all later, I gotta go. Hallelujah. I have fought a good fight. Good God. Hallelujah. I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness with the Lord, the righteous, hallelujah, judge, gave guilt to me on that day. And not to me only, I love that, not to her only, but to all of us that believe, but unto all of them also that love his appearing. Now I'm going to read the Living Bible translation. I say this because I won't be around to help you much very long. My time has almost run out. Very soon now I will be on my way to heaven. I have fought long and I fought hard for my Lord. And through it all, I have kept true to him. And now the time has come for me to start fighting and just rest. I'm not talking about W-R-E-S-T where you wrestling with some stuff you hadn't done. You're wrestling with things you can't let go. But I'm talking about R-E-S-T, rest. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. In the heaven, a crown is waiting for me, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day of his return. Now he's coming back. And not just to me, but to all those whose lives show that they are eagerly looking forward to his coming back again. And as a subject today, I want to talk to you about a good fight and a finished race. Hallelujah. Apostle Strawter fought a good fight and she finished the race. Hallelujah. Some of us might say it wasn't long enough, but somebody said it could have been the other way. But let me tell you something. I told you from the beginning, she did it her way. Hallelujah. We see that Paul's final earthly testimony is this. Hallelujah. In verses 6 and 7, he talked about what he has done. In verse 8, Thank you, Lord. He said, I have finished the race. He had no, listen, no opponent is mentioned in here, y'all. Hallelujah. He completed well in the contest of life. Not that he had won the race, but he had completed the race. Good God Almighty. Hallelujah. He ran the race according to the rules that were laid out by God. Sometimes we don't want to follow God's rule. We want to do it the way we want to do it. But at the end of the day, hallelujah, we got to come back to our center. And that center is Jesus Christ. Apostle Strawter knew it. She didn't care what it caused her help. She didn't care what it caused her. She was going to snatch somebody out of flames of hell. Somebody didn't hear what Pastor Strawter is saying today. Hallelujah. She fought. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I've been involved in that great struggle for Christ. Hallelujah. Not only that, he ran the race according to its rules. Some folk try to bend the rule at the bottom. You can't bend the rule at the bottom because you don't know the in-between stuff. You have to wait to get to the top in a position to change the rule according to the rule. Hallelujah. He said, I've guarded the deposit that was entrusted in him. He said, I've guarded that which God has given me, and I have obtained the victor's crown. So we have to make up our mind to hang in with the Lord through the tough times so that we can look back at the end and say with Paul, I have finished the course. You know what it is when you take classes in school. Oh, you're sweating bullets. Good God Almighty. Burning the midnight oil. But when you take the text and you get that A, you say, get the shot. You say, Lord, I finished that course. But there's a course of life that we have to finish, that we have to work out every day that we live. If you, let me tell you something. If you hate on somebody, stop hating on them. Because it's not going to infect them or affect them. The infection is on the inside of the one holding that mess. Hold on to God's unchanging. Hallelujah. Just be in that good fight and finish your course. Finish your race. Thank you, Lord. He said, I have kept the faith. When Paul said that he has kept the faith, he means that he has carefully guarded the truth about Jesus Christ that God had entrusted in him. Apostle Strawter, affectionately called KK, she protected that which God had given you. You praying for her while she's sick. She telling you now, stop right there and make sure you bind and rebuke the devil. Don't God not apostle, we pray. Hallelujah. She's going to make sure it's right if you're praying over her. Hallelujah. Somebody said, show you right. Woo! Hallelujah. He had not bought into many of the errors about Christ that was circulating in Paul's day. His life and his teaching held to sound doctrine. Paul could finish well because he could look at his present. How he could be in jail, but he still going to tell somebody, hallelujah, that the wages of sin is what? Death. Hallelujah. Gonna help him get there. And she was like that. She going to tell you whether you're ready for it or not. Get ready, get ready. Here she comes. Hallelujah. You might get upset at first, but in the end, you're so grateful. So thankful because this powerful woman understood. See, let me tell you something. One thing I admire about her, she'll tell you about her past. Hallelujah. But it was her past that caused her to walk heavily. If you've been where she been, if you had to go through the things that she had to go through, no wonder she walked heavily. She depended on the Lord because he snatched her out of the fire. Until you know somebody else's story, you can't appreciate the greater glory. Woo! Hallelujah. Thank you, Apostle, for sharing your story. Some folks, I wouldn't tell all that. That'll help you get free. See, it's when we conceal things, we can't be healed. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Paul, his present life. Hallelujah, his present life. He was
delivered and get set free and set them up and put them in a place they would turn around and come up against her. It'll sting her for a while, but God will take the stinger out of it. She'll go on to the next person. Somebody need to say amen. Hallelujah. Paul did not drop out of the race, and he had guarded the truth of the gospel, but he also looked to the future. See, he's a finisher. He finished. She finished to bring to absolute completion. Paul is telling us that he left nothing undone that he had been assigned to. This ought to be our goal. Do not be a quitter. Be a finisher, so that when we stand before the Lord on that mighty day, well done, and we might be able to say, I have finished my course. Hallelujah. The course of life is uncertain, but God, however, is it. Hebrews 12:1-2 and Hebrews 13:8 said, wherefore, seeing we are compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. I can hear Apostle Strawter saying it now. She'll say it in a minute. Have seen. Good God Almighty, hallelujah. Wherefore, seeing we are all compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily beset us, and let us run, y'all. Let us run, let us run. The Christian life is not a marathon. It's a long race, and it's not a sprint. Just like a marathon runner, many Christians start out well, but considerably few finish well. When we become born again, we all start out with the same equipment. Let me tell you what your equipment. Let me tell you. Number one, we are convicted of our sin, and we believe in God's grace by the same Holy Spirit. We are forgiven by the same sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. Number three, we are empowered by the same Holy Spirit and the same resurrection. Number four, so what makes the difference? We all started out with the same equipment. So what was it that made some able to see their race through to the end, while others fall by the wayside? First, how well did you train? How well did you train? Hallelujah. If you were going to hang with apostles, baby, you're going to be serving, giving, living, being fruitful, being faithful. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Second, how well did we persevere? If we learn to train ourselves well, and if we learn to persevere well, then we will certainly finish well. Hallelujah. Training well. On the other hand, almost there. On the other hand, discipline yourself for the purpose of godliness. Hallelujah. For bodily discipline is only a little profit, but godliness is profitable for all things, since it holds promise for the present life and also for the life to come, according to 1 Timothy 4:7-8. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, with the Lord, the righteous judge will award me, us, on that day. And not only me, but also to all who have longed his appearing. 2 Timothy 4:8. Here we see Paul's face shining so brightly, being in a prison, in a dungeon, doesn't matter where, that the darkness of the Roman prison cell seemed to disappear. It did not matter at all, because he knew, absent from the body, and to be present with the Lord. Hallelujah. By faith, he see beyond his own beheading. The pain of that moment is now past, and the suffering of this life is left far behind. By faith, he sees a day called death. receive his reward from the Lord, what will that reward be like? It will be a guaranteed reward. It is laid up or stored up in heaven for power. If stored up in heaven for apostle, it's stored up in heaven for us. If we have believed that Jesus is God's son, hallelujah, that he was buried, and on the third day he got up with all power in his hand. Good God Almighty, I'm so glad he got up, because he got up, I can stand up and stay up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It will be a glorious reward. It will be the crown of righteousness, the crown of righteousness. See, it will be a personal reward. Paul will receive his reward from the Lord himself. Note how specific he is about this. It is the Lord, the righteous judge, who will reward him. In just a few days, Nero, the unrighteous earthly ruler, will have him beheaded. This thing is real, y'all. But in that day, the Lord himself will reverse Nero's earthly judgment. Good God Almighty. In other words, God gonna turn it around. God, get ready to turn some stuff around for somebody in here right now. You better get the practice that he's turning it around. Hallelujah. The chief justice of the Supreme Court of the universe will weigh in on Paul's case, and his judgment will be final. And it will be personal. Paul won't be awarded his crown by mail, and he won't receive it from a committee. He will receive it directly from Jesus Christ himself. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. It will be a future reward. Paul will receive his reward on that day, the day Jesus Christ returned from heaven. Apostle will receive her reward on that day. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It will be a future reward. Thank you, Lord. It will be a shared reward. It's not just for Paul, but for everyone who loves the Lord and longs for his appearing. This is what is ahead for you and for me, if we would just faithfully serve Jesus Christ in this life. Be encouraged, children of God. The Lord is not so unjust as to forget your suffering. He sees all that you are going through. He sees all that you have gone through. He knows all about your struggle. He sees how hard you've been fighting, how you are sometimes tempted to quit, and how you keep on going when others around throwing the towel. Hallelujah. If you can't put one foot in front of the other, you better pick them up and pack it down under your feet. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So the word of the Lord is this. Keep on fighting. I don't care what it looks like. Keep on running. I don't care what they throw in your way. Apostle didn't let that stop her. Even when she was on a sick bed, oh, she'll dress herself up. Brother Prof. She'll fix herself up to look cute. Hallelujah. Knowing she's feeling bad, she'll look cute. Hallelujah. She would do that. Hallelujah. But we tell God, thank you. And Dad, you know. Priscilla, you know. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And let me tell you this, keep on running, keep on believing, and the best of all is yet to come. It won't be long now, just a little while, and the Lord himself will return, and all of our struggles will be over. Hallelujah, this hot battle won't last forever. This long road will soon come to an end, and this old world full of danger, toils and snare, it's going to be over. It won't last much longer. Hold on to your faith, child of God. Hold on and keep believing, child of God. Stay strong. Put on the whole armor of God. Hold on to your faith and never give up. There's a finish line out there. Somewhere it is closer than any of us realize. So in conclusion, I say to you, hallelujah, apostle, prophetess, and KK. Amen. She fought a good fight. And she finished it. So I say to each of us, finish strong. Finish strong. Finish strong. By the grace of God, let's finish strong for Jesus. Rest on, mama of God. See you in the morning.
With all of Works Ministries. You will truly be missed. Love, Apostle Tate, Pastor Linda. With the sympathy, Cole and Barbara Manson. With the sympathy, Myra Banks and family. Our condolences to the family, Michelle and CJ. With our deepest condolences to the entire family, love always, Jacinta, Michaela, and Makari. The family flower is giving loving memory of a loving and caring wife, mother, grandmother, sister, aunt, and friend from the family. In loving memory of Dr. Napoleon Williams, Deacon Arthur L. Parker, CEO and President, along with staff of J.W. Williams Funeral Home, is pleased to present to this family an African-American family heirloom Bible in the hope that it will serve as a source of added comfort and peace in the days to come. We are also pleased to present to this family a pictorial tribute of your loved one's life. It is our prayer that you will forever remember the many cherished memories you've shared as a family. And finally, present this memorial blanket. It is our prayer that you wrap yourself in the love and warmth that this blanket holds, and may it be a constant reminder of your beloved. For anyone that is never loved is never lost. It is our prayer that your blessing